Nel nome del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. Amén. Padre eterno, me uno con las intenciones y afectos de Nuestra Señora de los Dolores en el Calvario, y ofrezco a ti el sacrificio de sí mismo que te ofreció tu Hijo amado en la cruz, que renueva ahora en este santo altar. Yo lo ofrezco en el nombre de toda la humanidad, con todas las misas que ahora se ofrecen, y todas las que se ofrecerán alrededor del mundo en este día para esos fines, para adorarte y rendirte el honor debido, confesando tu dominio supremo sobre todas las cosas y la absoluta dependencia de todo en ti, quien es nuestro único y último fin, para agradecerte por los beneficios sin número que hemos recibido, para aplicar tu justicia provocada contra nosotros por tantos pecados, y para hacer satisfacción por ellos, para implorar tu gracia para mí, para tu santa iglesia, para todos los afligidos y sufrientes, para pobres pecadores, para todo el mundo, y para las benditas almas del purgatorio. Amén.
Among the gods there is none like you, O Lord, for you are great and do marvelous deeds. You alone are God.
In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti.
Amen.
Dominus obiscum et cum spiritu tuo.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie
eleison.
Christe eleison.
Israel, conviértete al Señor tu Dios, Dios tuyo,
to love him with all your heart, with all your understanding, with all your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself, is worth more than all burnt offerings and sacrifices. And when Jesus saw that he answered with understanding, he said to him, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." And no one dared to ask him any more questions. The Gospel of the Lord. We are all very familiar, of course, with these great commandments. We've heard them many times, but I would suspect that we have not reflected on them sufficiently, and certainly not in a practical enough way. Because if you really took to heart the words, "with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength," none of us would live exactly the way we're living right now. Because our hearts are given to many things. Our souls are filled with a lot of junk that we've put there over the years. Our minds become preoccupied with so many things that are not of God. And we are lazy. We half-heartedly follow Christ, and we certainly don't love our neighbor, because we've all gotten comfortable with the fact, as long as we're not being criticized, as long as we're being nice and not causing any trouble, then we are loving. But that cannot be the case using the standard that our Lord is reminding us of. Because it is a reminder. This is nothing new. This is the law of God. And we do not follow it. And of course, that's what Lent is all about. Lent is an acknowledgement of this so that we may do better and put into practice this love of God and love of neighbor through our prayer, our fasting, and our almsgiving. The fact is that we are incapable of following this law by ourselves, which is why we look at the collect of today's Mass. Pour your grace into our hearts, we pray, O Lord, that we may be constantly drawn away from unholy desires and obey by your own gift the heavenly teaching you give us. That gift is referring back up to the grace that we receive. We cannot love without the grace of God, because he is love, and the love that we are expected to love with can only come from him. By the graces of this Holy Mass, may we come to do so. En este Evangelio escuchamos los dos mandamientos más grandes. Jesús le respondió a este escriba: "El primero es: escucha, Israel, el Señor nuestro Dios es el único Señor. Amarás al Señor tu Dios con todo tu corazón, con toda tu alma, con toda tu mente y con todas tus fuerzas." Y si reflexionamos suficiente sobre este pasaje, que empezamos a hacer más frecuentemente, llegamos a un conocimiento de nosotros mismos que no lo hacemos, porque nuestros corazones son divididos, nuestras mentes están llenas con mucha basura y somos flojos. Y no podemos amar a Dios y a nuestro prójimo como debemos sin la gracia de Dios. En la colecta, oración colecta, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by your gracious gift each year, your faithful await the sacred Paschal feasts with the joy of minds made pure, so that more eagerly intent on prayer and on the works of charity, and participating in the mysteries by which they have been reborn, they may be led to the fullness of grace that you bestow on your sons and daughters. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Sanctus.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth and on the Catholic, and apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask, O Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace, through Christ our Lord. Amen. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live in of the Lord be with you always.
On your steady, we told each other.
Ese es el Cordero de Dios que quita el pecado del mundo. Dichosos sus invitados a la cena del Señor. Señor, no soy digno de que entres en mi casa, pero una palabra tuya bastará para sanarme.
strength be at work in us, O Lord, pervading our minds and bodies, that what we have received by participating in the sacrament may bring us the fullness of redemption, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum, et cum spiritu, benedica vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus. Ite missa est.
Deo gratias.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, most Sacred Heart of Jesus, sorrowful and immaculate Heart of Mary, Saint Joseph.